double crops. Putting some soybeans in the ground. Pretty dry. Definitely use the rain sometime soon. But we got all that straw out there on the ground. That'll help hold some moisture. Plus put some organic matter back in the ground. Got this field done today. Did pretty good. Not our best, but did pretty good. We'll take it. Can't complain. Hopefully we'll get a couple showers to get these beans up and get a decent double crop this fall. Got a little dust rolling back there. Are you done? Yapping? Nope. Are you done yapping yet? Got a suction chain that needs tightened up a little bit or something. Got a little ditch right there to flex through. Find it? Yeah, you found it. Oh, I got a little skipper. Come back and get that. pretty warm lately, in the 90s this whole week. Doesn't look like it's supposed to cool down anytime soon. Doesn't look like we're supposed to get much rain anytime soon either. But I think we're doing pretty good compared to other states and other parts of the states. Other parts of the state. Got plenty of grass in the pastures. Crops are looking pretty good. Just need a few showers this summer to keep everything growing. We will see. Pivot's been running up in Timberville. Keep on rolling, try to knock out a good bit of this field tonight. Got started on another field combining, and one of the draper belts, side draper belts on the header, came apart finally. It was starting to rip there at the seam back in the fall. I was just waiting for it to take a poop, and it finally did. So we gotta get that replaced in the morning. And then we can get back to whacking wheat. Hopefully get that finished up in a day. And then get these beans planted in a day, maybe two. And then that'll wrap up planting season. 2024, and I'll be back in the fields till the fall. We have our corn fertilized by a local company. They do pretty good with that. And they do a good bit of our spraying too. SL Hess and Sons in Harrisonburg. Got a sprayer, pull behind sprayer. Actually got it last year, I think. New Iva, I think it's called. Use it here and there to do a little spraying here and there on the crop fields, but we don't do all our spraying. Well, we're gonna keep on rolling. As much moisture as we can in it. With these Don't touch it.
Nope.
With these hot days, drier weather. It's hot out, ain't it?
Yeah,
hot. Feels good in here.
Okay, Daddy.
Yeah, you're being a monkey.
Yeah.
You been in the pool today?
Uh-huh.
Yep. Say we ought to go hop in the pool after this is done. Well, we started cutting this morning. Made a couple rounds and serpentine belt went out on the combine. Started losing power and cooling temperature was going up, so I had to shut her off. Went back in the engine bay and serpentine belt blew apart. So we'll have to get one of them. And next week, today's Saturday, maybe Huber can send a service tech down Monday, bring it down. If not, it'll have to ship it to us. That way we can get back to up and rolling. It's part of it. Sometimes you have breakdowns, sometimes you don't. You a snake? Yeah. Hey, look, there's a helicopter.
Yeah. Hi.
Say hi.
Hi.
Get back on my big D line here. Dude just flew right over us when we were filling up with seed not shortly long ago. Must like flying over us, seeing what's going on. Planting 160,000 double crop soybeans. Bump the population up a bit from the early planted soybeans. All right, 55 acres done so far. It's 80 couple in this field. So we should be able to knock it out today. Got all the end rows on. We're just gonna knock out these AB lines. Oh, where's our groundhog hole?
Yeah.
Tell Grandpa he needs to fill in his groundhog holes.
Yeah.
You go tell him?
Yeah.
Say we got groundhog hole. You fill it in. Hog hog. Hey, what are you doing? Hitting my arm. Stop. Wheat did pretty good. Had a good crop this year for wheat. Get these beans in and pray for rain, because we could surely use some. But I tell you what, we're in a lot better shape this year, this time of year, than we were last year at this time. Got a lot of grass in the pastures. Corn and soybeans look pretty good. Wheat did good. Just need a couple showers this summer to keep things growing. But can't always guarantee it's gonna rain. It's part of it. If your pastures look like a golf course, you may want to move your cows or quit making hay. See a lot of people complaining about the weather. If they change their ways they farm, maybe they wouldn't complain about it so much. Just a thought. That's why we try and farm, so that we can get through a drought whenever it comes about, because you can't guarantee that it's gonna rain. Bunched up a bit on that straw. Why? See Grandpa? What's he doing? See if it'll push it through. If not, we're right here at the end row. I'm not gonna worry about it. Getting at. Oh, dry weather. Dry weather, yep. That's why we don't till. That's why we don't take nothing off our fields to keep the ground covered and suppress as much moisture as we can, or not suppress. Hold as much moisture that we can, because it's gonna get hot in the summertime, and if you got bare ground, gonna cook. You gotta keep it covered with something. Stop hitting me, boy, or I'm gonna smack you. See all that straw down there? Of course, this monitor's being a picky little thing today. Moisture in there and catch whatever moisture we get. Straw didn't chop up as well in this field over here. It was a little green, had a little green still in it at the bottom. Didn't quite chop up as well in this field. Did better in fields to the north, and in the one field that I just started cutting today, it's chopping up real good. Wesley put himself on timeout. Now you're behaving. Don't smile. And that's also why we don't make hay. Leave it out there, let it grow big and tall, and let the cows eat it. Because if you just made hay off your fields and you get weather like this, boy, you're not gonna grow much grass anytime soon. But yet everybody still keeps doing it. I have no idea why. I guess they're still doing it like grandpa and grandma. Like to make hay all summer and feed it all winter. Not us, not anymore. Quit that long time ago. I like how it makes the back and forth lines, the dark and lighter lines when you're in wheat straw planting. I mean, it's almost, what is it, June 22nd, almost July, and there's people still making first cutting hay. I'm like, what are y'all doing? I mean, that stuff should have been made first week of May, if not the middle of May. I don't see how it can be any good of feed value when it's all matured out. And then you make hay off of it and dries out even more. I don't see how that's any better feed value than this straw laying out here on the field. Whatever. Everybody's different. Spend all that time and money making the stuff, and this wheat straw is probably just as good a feed. Oh well. Gives you something to chuckle about. See, it just didn't quite chop it up. See, it's a little thicker on the outside swath of where the combine spit it out. That's alright, we'll plant through it. We're planting on a little bit of an angle to try and avoid bunching up. Gotta get it off. I think most of it was 12-13% moisture, the wheat, so gotta get it off before it dries down too much more. And get these beans in, and shoot, we'll be done. Should be done planting double crops before July 1st, which is good. Good for us here in Virginia. Can't complain one bit. A Magnum 315 tractor. It's a 2012. Got almost 2,300 hours on it. So she's still got some good life in her. And a planter is a 1240. It's also a 2012 model. Had both the tractor and planter since 2017. Done pretty good. Might upgrade this planter after this year, we'll see. Probably look at getting a 2140 case. Up. like planting through all them corn stalks again, bunching up. There we go. Oh, you should have tilled it. You should have tilled it. You wouldn't have to plant through all that nonsense. Ah, thick spots. Push it out of the way. Come on. There you go. But yeah, we're just gonna have to keep an eye on it and where it's a little thicker. Make sure the planter runs through it. We didn't have any issues with that on the fields to the north. Just didn't quite chop it up as well, but it'll be all right. Well, we're gonna keep on rolling. Get this field knocked out this evening. And probably call it a weekend after that. Call it a week. Might check a cattle group for the evening, and tomorrow's Sunday. We'll take the day off and relax. Get back to it on Monday. We'll see you down the road, or see you down the rows. Say bye, Wesley.